Что это такое? И голоса. И голоса. Тут много голосов было. Да, и тянет куда-то вот сюда. Подождите. Где-то вот здесь. Как будто где-то вот совсем рядом.
Hold on. I got scratches in my shit. I already played this motherfucker. Hey now! From the four corners of the globe, it's Will Neff. Pleasure to be back. Let me find my fucking tempo.
Hey.
Yeah.
Light it up,
nigga.
Birdman,
motherfucker.
Come on, Lil, and handle your business for me, boy.
What happened to that boy?
Yeah.
What happened to that boy? What happened to that boy?
He was talking shit, we put a clap into that boy.
What happened to that boy?
Whoa.
What happened to that boy?
Yeah.
What happened to that boy?
He was talking shit, we put a clap into that boy.
I heard he snitching on a player, man, say it ain't so. Even as a youngin', they consigned me to blow. Which explains why I'm worth my weight in gold. While they was taking baby steps
from an 8 to an O.
Word in the streets that the envy is me. Enough ice on that watch to make a nigga lose sleep. Magnified face, help the bitch see clearly. Nine on the waist, hit the bitch up severely. I'm known for the flip of
that cocaine.
I'm heavy in the street like the 7 series Beamer, man. Hit him with the Nina, man. Or that 4/5 guarantee.
What's up, D-Pipes?
Man, whoa. I'm the reason that your block is vacant. Malicious will hit you just to make a statement, bitch. Clips and cash money, who ain't rich? Don't compare me to you, nigga. You ain't this, whoa. What happened to that boy? What happened to that boy? What happened to that boy? He was talking shit, we put a clap into that boy. What happened to that boy? What happened to that boy? What happened to that boy? He was talking shit, we put a clap into that boy.
Stunner and patty cake, the worldwide push. Birdman, nigga, leave the guns in the bushes. Bitch, shitting up bricks. Let him unload on the gusset. Balls are together with the round shape cooking shit. One throw one, nigga, flood the block.
Birds are flat.
Niggas sitting on the turlet, bitch, get off the pot. The bird just landed, so the hood gon' rock. New whips, big chips, the Prada Gucci shit. But mommy, you fly beans, the wide skinny lips. She takes my flight, she holds my weight. While the pork was staked out from state to state. It ain't nothing to a baller, baby. Pay the cost, big money, heavyweight, Birdman, hood boss, baby. Stepping on my line, I sure love something. May call it young, come out in the black crawl, touch, touch.
What happened to that boy?
What happened to that boy? What happened to that boy? He was talking shit, we put a clap into that boy. What happened to that boy? What happened to that boy? What happened to that boy? He was talking shit, we put a clap into that boy.
Ugh.
Ugh.
Hello.
The rims match, of course. Blood hit his Tim's. It
reminded them of them. Ugh. Ugh. I love that, dude. Ugh.
Oh, yeah, wow. That's very cool.
Madillon gifted a tier 1 sub to Dookie 1.
Oh, yeah, wow. That's very cool.
Madillon to Dookie 1. What a connection, baby. Hey, now. Hey, now. All right, so someone told me this is the formation I'm supposed to have on the mic, down and to the left.
Oh yeah, wow, that's very cool.
So if the mic sounds different, let me know.
From
damn
back of the Neff, parasocial love to William Neff.
Dude, Countess, you have been here a minute, dude. You have been here a minute. It feels like just a second. It feels like an instant. But man, deep pipes triggering those crazy alerts.
One, the most guanine and great streamers on Twitch.
I am pretty guanine. Deep pipes blowing it up. Damn, y'all. Thank you for all the bits. Praying that you have a COVID test coming back negative. Why? Are you feeling shitty?
Oh yeah,
was good for manic.
Cool.
We back.
Thank you so much. Lock me out, Deep Pipes. Rose Sark, man, this is a way to. Goddamn. We got. It's looking like Independence Day in this bitch with all these aliens flying around.
Hi y'all.
Hi. What's the plan for tonight? Not much planned for tonight. I'm gonna be honest. I did G4, and I did he's just a minor threat. Yes. What was I gonna say? I had Fear and Malding today, and then I went to G4, so my day was pretty packed. Guys, tomorrow we got an episode of Fear and Malding here, and that gonna want to miss. We got the one, the only Ludwig on Fear and Malding, and it was a doozy. It was a good one. Yo, WillNeff, what's up? My first stream. Whoa. Yo, WillNeff, what is up, my man? First stream,
oh, yeah, wow.
I'm catching.
That's cool.
Well, hey, yeah. Well, hey now. Peace and love, peace and love. I hope you enjoy your stay. My stream has a little bit of a different vibe to it. I hope it appeals to you. Yeah, so first of all, if this is your first stream, I'll give you a little bit of a rundown what we usually do. Oh, what the
shit from anyone.
I love how funny you are. Any tips or not?
I love how funny you are. Any tips or not? Tips on being funny? That's interesting. I'm gonna give you my number one tip to being funny. I think people really like self-deprecating humor. Whenever you can be self-deprecating and take the piss out of yourself, that's really great. D-Pipes, my God, a one-man hype train. Thank you, D-Pipes. Mental illness? Yeah, that's a good answer, too.
There are a lot of great streamers on Twitch, but I need to point out that we are lucky to be in the era of
WillNeff. Turn 21 tonight. Let's go, love you, Will, in chat.
Gosh, you guys are blowing it up. Thank you so much. Flossy Dicky Bounce, happy 21st birthday. Have a drink on me, buddy. Okay, tips to being funny. The other number one tip to being just humorous with someone else, not in front of a room, not for a living, but just with another person, is listening. I'm telling you, if you listen to what a person is saying, thank you so much, Voxymandias. Gosh, you guys just blew me up. Listening to what a person is saying, being engaged and reacting, elevated, right? People, I'm going to tell you right now, people laugh way more when I'm one-on-one with them. If you just take the piss out of what they're saying and you're really engaged with it, that's going to sound so trite, but I think a lot of times humor, it's interesting. Humor is almost like a mind state, right? When someone already knows that you are funny and anticipates that you're going to be funny, the task of being funnier or being funny is a lot easier, right? If you ever watch a really great stand-up, the first thing that they'll do is they will familiarize you with them. They will tell something about themselves that like grounds you, right? That makes you familiar to them. And part of that is like you want to be likable and you want to be engaged. So when you're just being funny in person, the more that you can get someone on board, to you just being a good dude, the more you're gonna.
From anyone.
Okay. Do you find being funny drains your mental health?
No, quite the opposite. Well, not all the time. No, usually for me, making someone laugh is like the greatest joy in my life. So typically, it's actually a source of like a lot of happiness for me. Actually, in fact, but there are times where I'm gonna be real. When you're the funny person and you want to have a quiet moment and you're not being funny, people assume you're having the worst day of your life. There's been a lot of times where I'll be out and I'll just be like sitting quietly having a beer, like just an introspective night. And everybody's like, what's wrong with Will? What the fuck? He's not dancing on the table. Something's off. He might be dying. Like, and that gets a little taxing. But other than that, I love making people laugh.
That's for a cool
Miss World, World Smartest Caterpillar. Thank you so much. I have found that almost all the people that I know who are professional comedians or comics, started by making someone in their family laugh. I remember I really got into being funny because my aunt worked at Morgan Stanley in New York City, and she was one of the few women who had an executive position. So she would come home every week just absolutely drained, like crushed. And she would cry. And usually she would take me on weekends because my mom was a flight attendant. So I was usually with my aunt. And that's like where I started doing like, you know, my lean 5 minutes, you know, just dick jokes to try and get my aunt to laugh or crack a smile. And that's kind of like where I fell in love with that process. But a lot of people I know started that way, right? Eddie Murphy started that way. Chris Rock, Howard Stern. A lot of like the comedians I respect the most started by doing living room sets for their family and fell in love with it. Yeah, for me, I drop lulls here and there. I wait for my moment and it boosts my happiness so much. There you go. But would you say you are naturally funny or not? I mean, I don't want to get Haas mods, but yeah, I'm very naturally funny, I would say. I just have a very comic sensibility. I think it has to do with like the way I view the world. Yeah, I think that everything is kind of a joke. And I think that helps. I think there are some people who just see the divine joke. The way I would put it is Bill Hicks put it beautifully one time where he basically said that all of life is a decision between love and fear. And, it's a ride, right? Life is a ride and we are trained to believe that this ride is important and that it means something, but at the end of the day, it's still just a ride. And some people forget that it's a ride. Some people forget that life is this kind of cruel and whimsical joke, and they think that their bank account is very important, and they think that their relationship with their wife is very important. And at the end of the day, nothing is really that important if you get enough perspective on it. So that's the way I tend to look at things. It doesn't mean that you have to be like a nihilist and a prick, but just don't take things so seriously.
I don't take no shit from anyone.
Here's the bit. All right, we'll
pull
that.
You know your timing, because I find that's the hardest part.
Timing. By the way, these are huge donations. Thank you so much. That's really great of you. I started doing comedy courses at a very early age. I worked in Chicago at Second City. I worked at Laugh Factory in Los Angeles, and I studied at the Groundlings in Los Angeles. And that certainly helped with timing. But I think that's just kind of something you develop over time.
Oh, yeah, wow. That's very cool.
Have you watched Comedians in Cars Getting Coffee? Lots
yeah.
of funny people talking about being funny. Seems good.
I'm going to be... Yeah, wow, that's very cool.
I'm going to keep it a buck. I'm going to keep it 100. This is a laser hot take. I don't think Seinfeld is funny. I think his show is very funny because of Larry David, but I have never found Seinfeld even remotely funny. In fact, I find him to be like probably way more arrogant than he deserves to be. There's been multiple times in his career where he will point out the fact that he's the highest paid comedian in history. And like, it's so brooksome and it's so like, abby funny, right? One of the great examples of that is Mitch Hedberg. Right, Mitch Hedberg is one of the funniest people that ever lived. He wore glasses on stage because he was so painfully afraid of getting on stage. Mitch Hedberg.
That's very cool.
Crazy 27th months. Miss proud of you.
Here's a little Mitch Hedberg right here. Mitch Hedberg would wear colored glasses because he had stage fright, and you can see by his delivery. He's deeply socially uncomfortable, but he was a fucking genius. Here you go.
All right, thank you. Hello. This is my second time on the show. All right. I mean, the first time must have been okay. But they say during the summer that drinks are ice cold. I hope not, because that means they would be impossible to drink. Because they would be solid. Here's a beer, man. It's just ice cold. Damn it. I guess I can lick it. I read that last year MTV's Real World got 40,000 applications.
See, his eyes are closed. He would get so many nerves on stage that he would literally freak out. This is considered by many like a top 100 stand-up of all time. And even he was so deeply uncomfortable that he had to close his eyes on stage.
That's amazing, man. Such an even number. You would think it would be 40,008, maybe. Yeah, man. I got a lamp in my hotel room and it has a three-way light bulb in it. If you don't know a light bulb's a three-way light bulb, it messes with your head. Because you go to turn it off and it just gets brighter. Like, damn it, light bulb, that's the exact opposite of what I want you to do. Then you turn it again and it gets brighter once more. I will break you. That's the only reason I had this thing out here. Oh, yeah, man. I saw a commercial that said, forget everything you know about slipcovers. So I did. And it was a load off my mind. Then the commercial tried to sell slipcovers, but I didn't know what the hell they were. It's a hippopotamus or a really cool apotamus. That's good. I want to rob a bank with a BB gun. Give me all your money or I will give you a dimple. I will be rich, you will be cute. I got a belt on that holds up my pants, and my pants have belt loops that hold up my belt. What the hell is really going on down there? Who is the real hero? Now, if I was a drummer and I accidentally grabbed... That'd be cool if you were a drummer and you accidentally grabbed two magic wands instead of drumsticks. You're pounding out the beat. Next thing you know, your bass player turns into a can of soup.
All right. That is the dumbest joke I've ever heard.
Can we take that joke out? Can we edit it? I love cottage cheese. That's why I want to try other dwelling cheeses, too. I want to try studio apartment cheese. Or maybe igloo cheese. Or if I'm feeling adventurous, mobile home cheese. Don't eat mobile home cheese during a tornado. It would be devastating.
D-Raw, man, you're joking about him being a legend, right? No, this dude is goated in comedy, man. And he died so young. He's one of the most pure joke writers ever. Like, he did so much with his punchlines, and he had his completely own style. He basically was like a remnant from like the early age of comedy. Like the Rodney Dangerfield of stand-up, where it was like, take my wife, please, take her.
You're trying to be funny with your buddy. Is it a confidence thing? Because I have jokes in my head, but never say them, if you know what I mean.
Yeah, as I said, performance is a confidence thing. Performing a joke is a confidence thing, right? The thing.
That's for cool.
You can come up with something funny, but delivering it the right way is part of the struggle, right? If you don't give your joke time to breathe and you rush through it and you're uncomfortable, sometimes it doesn't land as much. So, I mean, sometimes that can be endearing, but you got to just give yourself time. I think you when you're trying to be funny, I think you have to live with the fact that if you're not funny, what's the worst that happens? Someone doesn't laugh? Like, whatever. So it's kind of like the same, like the dating conundrum. Like, oh, I want to meet a person, but I can't put myself out there. Well, it's like, well, why not? Why are you not putting yourself out there? You're afraid of being rejected? Well, fuck it. We all do. We get rejected. You know what I mean? Just keep going.
Dr. Scholl makes foot products, and he's a doctor, which means he went to school for a long time. But it doesn't take a lot to figure out that stepping on a cushion will be more comfortable. That dude wasted lots of time at school. Because I would have bought that from a Mr. Show. I wish they made fajita cologne, because that stuff smells good. I hate to sleep because... No, I like to sleep, actually. I hate to dream, because dreaming takes energy. It takes work. Sleeping is supposed to be a relaxing affair. I lay down on a bed, it feels great. Next thing you know, I have to build a go-kart with my ex-landlord. Hey, if you can't sleep, count sheep. Don't count endangered animals. You will run out. I bought a donut and they gave me a receipt for the donut. I don't need a receipt for a donut. I'll just give you the money, then you give me the donut and the transaction. We don't need to bring ink and paper into this.
Oh, yeah, wow. That's for a cool.
Love you,
Brasky. I just can't imagine a scenario.
Thank you so much.
To prove that I bought a donut. Some skeptical friend. Don't even act like I didn't get that donut. I got the documentation right here. I saw this lady on TV. She was born without arms. She was born with her hands attached to her shoulders, and that was sad. But then they said, Lola does not know the meaning of the word can't. And that, to me, was actually kind of worse in a way. You know, not only does she not have arms, but she doesn't understand simple contractions. All right, thank you very much, lady.
Anyway, Mitch Hedberg is... If you've never seen his stuff, if you're unfamiliar with him, he's a guy who had a style that was all his own. Again, his name is Mitch Hedberg, H-E-D-B-E-R-G. I highly recommend you go check him out. You'll be cackling the entire time you do. There's not a ton of material of Mitch's because he didn't live that long, but he's a brilliant, brilliant guy.
I think Pringles and...
Here you go. Here's one more joke. Here's the Pringles joke. This is a great joke.
I think Pringles' initial intention was to make tennis balls. But on the day that the rubber was supposed to show up, a big truckload of potatoes arrived. And Pringles is a laid-back company. They said, fucking cut them out.
So dumb.
To people who don't know who...
It's so dumb. I love how dumb it is. I love how irreverent it is. He's got super irreverent humor. But, you know, like, with the confidence thing, it's amazing. I think Mitch and a lot of my other favorite comedians have what I would refer to as Pagliacci syndrome, where it's like they are people that have a lot of sadness on the inside. And they're, you know, just killing themselves to make you laugh. Maybe it has to do with how unhappy they are. And so they have so much empathy that they don't want anybody else to feel that way. Chris Farley has this famous quote where he's like, people need a dope to laugh at. They need someone to slip on a banana peel. They need someone to be the dingus so they can look at you and go, ha, at least I'm not that guy. And I love that quote. Anyway, that was kind of a long form conversation about comedy. A nice way to start the stream. How's everybody doing? You should play Dark Souls. I've played Dark Souls before. I beat Sekiro and I beat Dark Souls 3. I'm waiting for... I should probably get my PlayStation in here and beat Demon Souls sometime. But yeah, I love me some From games. From games be slapping. They be slapping. Will is a nameless king killer. I am. That I am. The nameless king to me wasn't as hard as some other shit. The nameless king was hard. The nameless king, dude, the hardest fight though. In a FromSoft game, in my opinion, I know everybody has different opinions. A lot of people say it's that Lovecraftian motherfucker what's the fucking Bloodborne. Some people say it's the Demon of Hate. Some people say it's, what's her name, Freyda? From Dark Souls 3, Freya. I forget her name. But for me, bro...
So you decided to go for the purification ending, and you made it...
I'm telling you, Owl 2... Owl 2 almost broke me. Owl 2 is so fucking hard, bro. That man whooped my ass. But I loved... I loved Owl too. Ish she? Who is Ish she? Which one is Ish she? Is she was a monster? Oh, the Sword Saint? You thought the Sword Saint was harder than Owl 2? You're crazy. I beat the Sword Saint. Hey, look at this. Hey, look, wait, where did this come from? Yep. Bro, that's when I started taking streaming so much more seriously. That was peak COVID. I was locked in my room. I was going crazy. And I lost to that first boss. It was my first From game. So I fucked that controller up. I waited. I got in bed. I waited 3 hours. I couldn't sleep. I drove to fucking Best Buy during the pandemic. I waited in line in front. I went in. I fucking bought the last controller, drove home, started streaming again, and beat her. And I was like, hell yeah. I was listening to Time by Pachanga Boys, my lock-in song. Someone asked if I looked at LSF.
Wow, that's for a cool...
Yeah, I did. I didn't see anything that was like a relevant story to me. Is there something I should be looking at on LSF? It kind of all seemed pretty mid today. LSF just kind of looked like very mid fails. I just want some more Rust RP. Rust RP? God damn, bro. Rust RP is hard without the Rust RP server. Like, GTA RP I can do. Rust RP, I kind of need the thing for it. Yo, what the fuck? XQC has 106,000 people watching, and he's just watching Gordon Ramsay chopped? Why does he have so many people watching? What the fuck? Ludwig? Yes. No one else is live? What? XQC, Aiden Ross, Summit, Hassan, Penta, Tina, Coil, Moist Critical... Iron Mouse, Melody, Mango, Sanchovies, Murder Crumpet. Dude, so many people are alive. What the fuck? LSF is good today. No, it's not. I just looked at it. It's dog shit. There's a chess one. There's a toast joke that is like, it's only clipped because he mentions Pokey in it. There's a Shroud clip of him reacting to subs. There's a Dr. K taken out of context. There's another chess clip. Yes. Real Ludbuds, watch WillNeff. Hey, let's go, Ludbuds. I hope I inherited at least a few Ludbuds with Ludwig leaving. I'm not as action packed as Lud. I gotta get way more active about like framing my streams like him. I just don't have time. I gotta be like, hey boys, today we're gonna fucking try all these flavors of Doritos. Something like that. I moved here from Ludwig Stream like 6 months ago. Wow, thank you. That's really nice of you. I wouldn't change anything about your stream currently. It's perfect, just like you. Aw, thank you. Yeah, I mean, my stream has a much more relaxed vibe. It's like much more of like a podcast, in my opinion, than it is a stream. You inherited this Ludbud a while ago? Let's go. Clear schedule would be cool. Okay, I'll work on it. I'm sorry, guys.
Ludbud,
but I've also been here for months.
Thank you. Of the top 1,000 streamers, I am the one that has like the most normal jobs. Thank you for supporting Ludwig. We're offering current subscribers to Ludwig like you a one-time offer to claim a free 1 month subscription at your current subscription tier to another channel. So as long as you are not a current subscriber to that channel, search for the channel below to redeem this offer. Once you redeem it, we cannot make any changes. What the fuck? That's crazy. Is that real?
Oh yeah, wow, that's for a cool.
Came for the sake.
Satanism. Stayed for the blood orgy.
That's what they always say. They came for the Satanism. Showed up for the Satanism.
Cool.
Yep.
Oh, Groovy Angel just did it, I guess.
Oh yeah, wow, that's for cool.
Thank you. Have you ever heard of Jingle Jam? Today was the first day and they've already raised a lot of pounds, I suppose. Any movie tonight? I think so, maybe. What was I gonna say? I've never heard of Jingle Jam, no, but I've heard they do good stuff.
Oh yeah, wow, that's for cool.
Showed up for the Satanism. Stayed for Satanism.
Oh yeah, wow, that's for cool.
Over 1 year of drinking skooma, inhaling Scythies. Blessed be the Dark Lord.
Oh yeah, wow, that's for cool.
Hell yeah.
Oh yeah, wow, that's for cool.
Thank you, Just Mumford. Thank you, Kaibot. Thank you, Phil FYM. And thank you, H Head Stall. Irie, let's see if there's any new movie trailers. I'm in the mood. I'm fin to watch some new movie trailers. One sec. Yes. Oh! There's a new Donkey video. Hell yeah. I fucking love me some Donkey. Let's get into it.
Donkey Kong. December.
Hey.
Donkey Kong.
Oh, yeah, wow. That's very cool.
Happy 6 month, Willard.
Where'd you get all those bananas?
Jades wants to watch Hellraiser with us. We already watched Hellraiser, but I'll watch Hellraiser 2 with Jades.
Donkey Kong.
Lysippius, thank you.
Remember,
oh yeah, wow, that's very cool.
With his mouth shaking.
Thank you, Mini Bro.
Oh yeah, wow, that's very cool.
Donkey Kong December, Donkey Kong December, Donkey Kong December,
Donkey Kong.
This whole month, I'm only doing Donkey Kong videos. This month. Hit you in the head with a big old bump. Shoot you in the head with a big old bump. Monkey Kong December, Donkey Kong December.
Basically just took a spear and flattened it, then bent it over, and it was basically Donkey Kong's mouth.
That's Donkey Kong's mouth.
Thank you, Mini Bro!
Every day this month, I will upload Donkey Kong. Say I'm
Thank you, Safri.
No More Parties by Cream Soda was my top song for 2021 on my Spotify.
What is this video? This is like a fever dream. Thank you, Lock Me Out. Someone said Cream Soda was their No More Parties was their number one song of the year on Spotify. That's interesting because this was my number one song of the year on Spotify. So this was my number one song. My number one artist was... my number one artist was Floating Points with Pharoah Sanders. Thank you, Coachman11111. And it's because... Thank you, Kanye.
2 months in this groovy stream.
It's because I listen to this album when I hike every day. Not only that, but...
Oh, yeah, wow. That's very cool.
Frank.
I love this album so much. I actually bought the LP. Very worth it. If you've never listened to this, if you are someone who meditates or spends any time being introspective, this is just about my favorite album ever for that. And then my number two song of the year, I was very, very proud of my number two song of the year. It was this. Did my internet just die? That was really weird. It said I wasn't connected to the internet. Okay. This. Dude, I play... Dude, mornings where I am tired, I put this shit on the way to work, and I crank it the fuck up. Gold. Thank you, Bong Hits, for burning. Bro, I am flabbergasted. Maybe I'm crazy, but my man is literally just watching Gordo. Like, silently watching Gordo, and he's got 110,000 people watching him. That's crazy. That's nuts! Yes. Bam, 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 bam. Amateur, 7 spectacular months. Love you, Will. Thank you so much.
Oh yeah, wow, that's very cool. Bam,
bam, bam. 7 spectacular months. Love you, Will.
Can I borrow $20? My mic arm broke while I was streaming last night. Yes. Shiny Kelvin, you need a new mic arm? I'm trying to think if I have a mic arm. I might actually have a mic arm. Discord and my mods. I'm going to check if I have a mic arm tonight.
Oh, yeah. Wow. Cool.
Jupiter 3330. Thank you. Yes. Any side talk reacts today? Side talk.
Wow. That's for a cool.
I did.
Kemp gifted a tier one sub to Xin Swag.
They Bing bang.
And gift subs in the channel.
Thank you. I did break my mic arm. I remember that now. DM anyway. We'll figure it out. Any update on those turtlenecks? No. Listen, I'll text the guy right now. Bing bang. Bam, banana. Bam, bam, bam. Nope, wrong Dan. What's good, bud? How's our timeline?
Yes. Okay. Bam, banana.
Bing bang. Who is a mod?
That's people who
modulate
7 months
the chat.
And I find myself recently falling asleep to the Gladiator streams. You are one of my favorite streamers and a real inspiration.
Thank you.
Neff cool.
Oh yeah, wow. That's for a cool.
Chimbrel, thank you. Name of number one song. It's Cream Soda. The song is in Russian though, so I don't know the name. Sorry. Just go listen to All of Cream Soda. All of Cream Soda is pretty fucking good. Is Diablo 2 Resurrection worth it? I don't know. It was for me, but I'm a streamer, and Diablo is one of my favorite games. But they really didn't add anything new. I was pretty surprised that they didn't add anything new. I don't know if they have now. Have they added new shit now? I don't know. Have you watched the Book of Boba Fett trailer yet? Book of Boba Fett? The fuck is a Book of Boba Fett? What the fuck is this? Is this a show or a movie?
I am Boba Fett. Left for dead on the sands of Tatooine. Jabba ruled with fear.
Oh, yeah, wow. That's very cool.
I intend to rule with respect.
The Book of Boba Fett, streaming December 29th on Disney Plus. Streaming December 29th.
What are these mini ads? What the fuck? Just show us a full ad, you dingus.
I am not a bounty hunter.
Okay, I can't do this. I'm sorry. It's just a bunch of like mini ads. It's gonna fucking really piss me off. Listen, I wish I could sit here and tell you that I wasn't excited for this, but it's Boba Fett, man. It's like Venom. Like, I wish I could sit here and be like, yeah, I'm not totally juiced, but I'm fucking juiced. It's Boba Fett. Robert Rodriguez is the showrunner. Interesting. New Matrix trailer. I don't know if I need to watch this. I feel like I know exactly what is going to happen in the Matrix. In fact, I made a prediction about it. So when the Matrix comes out, we can weigh my prediction against what actually happens. But we'll watch it.
A deja vu is usually a glitch in the Matrix. It happens when they change something.
Jefferson Airplane?
It happens when they change something. It happens when they change something. They change something.
Okay, I was wrong. This trailer fucking rules. I'm dumb. I'm sorry. Bing bang.
A deja vu is usually a glitch in the Matrix. It happens when they change something. It happens when they change something. It happens when they change something.
Okay, I was wrong. This trailer is dope as hell. Bing bang.
A deja vu is usually a glitch in the matrix. It happens when they change something.
Get it? I did a deja vu.
Happens when they change something. When she's 10 feet, it happens when they
Why use old code to mirror something new?
Maybe this isn't the story we think it is.
マトリックスの正体を知りたければ
確かめろ。 What the fuck?
Time to fly. This is it. This is your last chance.
I never believed I was the one, but she did.
We were on our way to remake your world.
I know it's why you're still fighting and why you will never give up. Come on, Neo, fight!
Matrix Resurrections.
Matrix. Matrix. Wakarimashita.
Okay. I've given my take on the Matrix. Listen, the first Matrix is a fucking work of art. Okay? The first Matrix is a goddamn work of art. An immortal film. One of my favorite films of all time. Unfortunately, I don't think the Wachowskis have made a passable film since. I'm just going to keep it a buck. I haven't liked anything. I haven't liked a single film that they've done since then. Speed Racer? No. I didn't like Speed Racer. I'm sorry. Animatrix? They didn't do Animatrix. What the fuck? The Wachowskis didn't direct Animatrix. It's okay to be wrong? Really? What hill are you gonna die on there? Yes. Someone said V for Vendetta. Bro, that film is not... Why? Do people think the Wachowskis directed things that they didn't? I mean, let me look at it. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe I'm an asshole. Maybe I'm an asshole. No. No, I'm not an asshole. No. Oh, they did the screenplay? That's not directing, though. No, I'm not an asshole. Let me put it this way. Compared to The Matrix, even if you like these other films, even if you're like, Speed Racer was okay, it doesn't even hold a fucking candle to The Matrix. It's not even in the same goddamn stratosphere. So, what the fuck are we even talking about? Speed Racer is better than The Matrix? Dude, stop smoking ayahuasca before you fucking watch Twitch, man. I'm telling you, put the pipe down, son. You're too young. Put that put that fucking meth down. Don't get ill, Sherm, Dust, PCP, Primo before you watch my stream. That is a ludicrous take. You are a madman. You are a fucking psycho. You just went on a list somewhere. Deadass. The government monitors that group of people harder than they monitor terrorists. Is Austin Show here? I see a lot of people reaching out to Austin Show. Redline is better than Speed Racer. 100 times out of 100 times, I'll agree with you on that. What's up, Austin Show? You want to talk to me? You want to jump in here? What the fuck do you have to say to me, motherfucker? I'm calling you right now.
Austin Show.
Yes, Austin Show. This is William Neff. How are you?
Good to hear from you. It's Austin Show.
Hello, Austin Show. This is Will Neff. How are you?
I'm doing fantastic. Just putting my OBS together for tomorrow's show.
What show is that?
It's the talent show.
Ah, I see. It's the finals.
No, the third. The third episode.
Ah,
which
third.
Is one episode short of the finals. I wish it was the finals.
When?
Nothing prepared for the finals.
Oh.
You know what I mean? You know when you're just like, God, if the show was ending on this one, that'd be great.
Yeah, you're
another one to do.
You're done with the stress if that happens. Oh my goodness. Well, flip my nips and call me Nancy. G4 just raided, and I mean
G4 raided,
and what an amazing time for y'all to raid, because I am talking to the one, the only Austin Show.
That's right. It's me, Austin Show. I used to, you know, show more often. Well, that sounds like I'm just like...
That sounds like you're flashing people, Austin.
Say, like I was exposing myself.
Yeah, that sounds... That sounds like you're running up to people in the parking lot of a Sam's Club with a trench coat.
Yes.
Austin Show!
It's Austin Show.
God, that was gonna be my talent for the talent show.
It's just me, you exposing yourself to the audience.
Yeah, it's just me.
I love it. I think it's fantastic.
Yeah.
Do you know what I do sometimes? Something to do, and then I'll take an edible before I have to do it, and it's a race against time.
Yeah, before you get too high.
Exactly. So like, that's what I've done this evening to. Mm-hmm. I took it about 10 minutes ago. I'm putting together my OBS for the show tomorrow, and it's like a race against that. Now I'm talking to you.
Yeah.
So,
yeah,
wow, which I'm for a cool so happy to
do.
Literally a race against time. I'm not a good multitasker normally.
Yeah.
But I can't wait to wake up in the morning and see how fucked up my OBS looks. And
I used to play that game a lot. I used to do that with college papers, where... You ever do that? I did that with college papers, where I would start writing the paper and I would like get done 2 hours later, high as a, you know, draft pussy. And I would, and I thought I'd really done some shit. You know what I mean? I'd be like, I laid it down. And then I would read it the next morning and be like, oh God, what the hell is this?
What the fuck did I just do? Yeah. No.
There's three paragraphs about Lucky Charms in here. This is supposed to be an essay about George Washington.
Yeah, no, you know, believe it or not, I didn't actually smoke weed in high school.
Really?
Or high school, fuck, college. And neither, I lost my weed virginity when I was 18, which, you know, I don't, it was illegal. I mean, weed wasn't even legal at the time, fuck it.
I've told you the story of the first time I smoked weed, right?
Tell it again, I love it. I love your welcome stories.
I smoked weed that my friend had grown.
Oh, like, that's always great.
When I was like a freshman in high school, we skipped class and we went home, and my friends and I were smoking weed behind a shed, and it was lightning hot in Princeton.
Oh my God.
So we were all shirtless, and my friend's very hot sister came back and caught us. And so we like all froze, and she was like, what are you guys doing back here? And we're like, nothing. Get out of here, dude. And apparently, like 10 years later, she told us she thought we were all gay. and that we were like that we were like exploring each other's bodies.
Oh my god.
Behind the shed when we were just degenerate stoner teens. But it was so funny.
Like, there was a time when I thought everybody was gay growing up.
Yeah.
There's a period when you're like going through adolescence where everybody's talking about jerking off.
Mm. Yep.
And that's all I wanted to talk about.
Was jerking off?
Was jerking. Back when I was an adolescent, at the time I was in the closet, but I really got off to talking about with my friends about jerking off. You know what I mean? Like that was my big thing. I was like, let's talk about jerk. Well, what hand do you use, bro? You know, it's like, yeah, well, why don't we just, you know, do it together just to see if we like it. You know what I mean? Like no homo. Like I just want
to. Listen, dude, it's only gay if you enjoy it. We're just going to do it together to save time. It's more efficient.
It's true. It's true. I tell you what, there was this one guy that I went on a trip to yeah. London. This is like years ago. He's probably not listening. I know him still. We're still friends. But like the entire trip was around us having a threesome. We were like trying to like get laid together.
Yeah. You,
and he was totally down with it.
Yeah.
And
The girl never showed up and you were going,
no, but like
we could just pretend. And
at one point we were out at a club and we had gotten, oh my God, we had pulled like four women. And I had slept with two women at the time.
Right.
Not really confident to have like an orgy. Right.
Sure.
Like you have to be at a different level of confidence for an orgy. So So we were at the club and we finally like get really close and we pull like four Swiss German women that we're about to take back to our hotel room in Chelsea, which is like, it was like somewhere in London. I don't know if you guys are familiar with London. And anyway, we're just about to get going and then one of the friends pukes on another one of the friends. Just
chain reaction.
Yeah, and then one of them starts crying. And it just turns into a fucking shit show.
Oh, God.
And so we ended up, then we're like, oh, fuck it. This is not going to work. We had, you know what oyster cards are? You know, in London, oyster cards are the way you get around. You can't use cash on the buses.
Okay.
So we try to go on the bus. We're like, oh, fuck it. We'll go back home. We try to go on the buses and our oyster cards don't work because they're negative money. Right. So we are stuck in central London in Piccadilly Circus in the middle of the night, miles away. We didn't have money for a cab and we were just stuck without pussy. For me, I didn't get to see his dick and like just helpless.
Would you have had sex with a woman just to see your friend's penis?
Dude, I would still have sex with a woman to be like, I'll be honest. If I could, I would have sex with a woman if a guy was present that I really was attracted to. I think that would be cool. I would probably enjoy watching. Is this too much? Am I going too far?
I mean, it's my stream. I don't care.
But like, yeah,
the G4 audience just came in here where they're not even allowed to swear.
Change. Sorry. Like I would actually, yeah, some people are masturbating right now. They're like, no, keep going.
Yeah, dude, they came from G4 to Austin's penthouse forum.
Yeah.
We pulled like four chicks. It was very hot.
Oh, God. I think the last time they came in, it was at the worst time.
Yep.
Hold on one second. What? How many MS? How many MS and what transition? Sorry.
Oh, dude, that edible be hitting when you're sounding out when you have to say out loud what you're typing.
I'm trying. Anyways,
that's for a cool.
But dude, I'll be honest. Like, oh God, I remember this.
Sure.
This is when I was like had my sexual awakening. I wish I'll tell this to my friend one of these days. He may hear this inadvertently, but like he was Swedish. He was Swedish. And by the way, if you're listening, my Swedish friend, don't worry. I don't have this attraction anymore, so it won't be weird when we hang out one of these days.
Does this Swedish person watch me? Or you're just covering all...
I'm covering all the bases just in case the Swedish person gets...
Oh, the fuck? What do you hear this conversation, Austin?
I don't know. Who knows? Wait, are we not... Should we not talk about this?
No. I'm just saying... I find it hilarious that you're covering your bases for someone who doesn't even watch Twitch. Oh, yeah,
wow. Well, you never know when a clip could... He'll definitely know it's him. So anyway, I like stayed at his house and he was super built and like I stayed there and like I slept at his house like in a separate bed. And I remember having like European men wear like this fucking sexy ass underwear, like this, like just tight.
Yeah.
Fucking whatever it was called. Sure. What it was. It was like, I don't know what the hell. Some fucking underwear.
Oh, yeah. No, I think I know that brand. What was that brand again?
Yeah. I had the hair left.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. So it's something. It's some sort of fucking Swedish Norwegian brand.
Oh, yeah. Wow.
And I remember just like literally he would come in and go to, you know, before he'd go to sleep and he'd come in these fucking nice, he was fucking shredded in like these briefs. And you know, Swedish men, I shouldn't say no further. You know, I mean, Norwegian, there's definitely, you know, they're packing, you know, something.
Some ding dong.
Anyway, for all the straight men in the chat that don't understand this, imagine you are in a room and this gorgeous woman comes into the room with her panties and a bra and she looks like a Victoria's Secret model. Like that's
yeah.
The visual. That's the type of... So anyway, like it was just a very rough time for me. I mean, it was a rough and also cool time, but also like a very rough time. But yeah, man, I don't know where I was going with that, but I just wanted to...
Yeah, you kind of just were really just went on a 10-minute tangent about the Swedish guy's dong.
I never saw it. I never saw
it. I love there is no point to that story.
It's just me describing how hot he was in boxer briefs.
Wait, I literally thought that was going to go somewhere, and it just ended with, you know, Swedish guys, they got big penises. That edible be kicking.
I don't know, dude. It's just like the edge. I kind of like don't know how much I took.
Sure.
So we'll see what happens.
When are you going to get your ass back to Los Angeles?
Next week.
Ooh.
I'll be back next week.
I love that.
Yeah, you know me. I'll be back next week.
I'm moving. I had Ludwig on the podcast today.
Yeah, I saw that. I saw his story, which, by the way, he never posts when I'm on the podcast on his story. Actually, no, he did. He did. He did post.
And,
but I imagine with Ludwig, you guys all took a picture together and posted on your Instagrams?
I haven't posted one, no.
Okay, but you guys took a picture together and Hassan is going to post a picture on his Instagram?
Probably, yeah.
Yeah. That never happens for me, ever.
Oh, I'm
he
sorry.
Never, ever, while we're doing a podcast together, he never takes a picture of all of us and posts it on his
Instagram.
Like, oh, we had Austin show on Fear and Malding. You know why? It's because I watch his stream all the time. I'm just another chatter. So it'd just be like, oh, hey, look, we had a random chatter on the podcast. Irrelevant, insignificant. Nobody cares. You know what I mean? Yeah. I think it's homophobic, to be honest with you.
Yeah, I thought so, too.
Right. Oh, speaking of which, really hot take that I had on Hassan's stream last night. Super hot take.
Okay.
A lot of people think Chick-fil-A is homophobic, right?
Yes.
Hot take. I think they're homoerotic. And here's why.
This is a lightning hot take. You think Chick-fil-A, the chicken sandwich. Okay.
Let me tell you why.
Go for it. Yeah, tell me.
Because me, a gay man, receives pleasure from eating Chick-fil-A. Therefore, they are pleasuring homosexuals, making them homoerotic. Right?
Oh, yeah. Wow.
Think about
that's
it.
That's for a cool.
Huh? They're giving pleasure to gay men. They're homoerotic, which is also a very big fuck you because they're so religious and they're so quote unquote anti-gay. But how could you be so anti? They're just in the closet. That's what it is.
Austin, couldn't you make the argument that everything could be homoerotic then?
What do you mean? Like, give me another example.
A chocolate bar.
How could that be homoerotic?
Because it gives you pleasure.
Yes, it is. Okay, that's right. That's what I'm trying to say. The whole world is gay and homoerotic.
Okay.
Think about it.
Yeah.
Think about it. So much as you are pleasuring gay men and women and everybody across the spectrum, the entire world is homoerotic.
I think the term in question is erotic. You know, it's pleasurable, but it's not erotic. Erotic means that you derive sexual pleasure.
Well, did I stutter?
You receive sexual pleasure from a chicken sandwich?
Are you kidding me? It's the best climax that I've ever received. Is from a chicken sandwich.
Are you fucking your chicken sandwiches?
No, I'm not fucking my chicken sandwich.
Austin, you can tell me. Are you fucking?
To be honest, I've actually never understood what the whole deal is mixing like sex with like food.
Yeah, I've never.
Like, those are two different parts of my brain.
I've never been a sex food guy. I've never been a
sex food guy.
I've never been a sex food guy. In fact, I'm the opposite. I usually feel like if I eat before sex, the sex is lethargic.
And you're bloated.
And I'm bloated. I don't feel sexy.
Oh, yeah, wow. Yeah. That's very cool.
True.
I just love sex.
Yeah.
I just really do. God, I just love it so much.
We know.
You think I could ever get a job outside of streaming? With that sort of talk?
Yeah. I mean, it depends on what... Are you going to be...
You think I could work for Microsoft and be on a stream and be like, yeah, God, I love fucking...
No.
On the board of directors?
No.
You know what I mean?
You could watch the stock price plummet.
But the thing is like, what? They don't...
I'm gonna tell you right now. If you were on the board for Microsoft... And you were at some tech summit and you were like, yeah, the new features, Windows 18 is going to be great. Let me tell you. And then someone's like, hey, recently I read your take on Chick-fil-A. And you're like, yeah, follow my logic. I enjoy chicken sandwiches. So Chick-fil-A is homoerotic. I get sexual pleasure from chicken sandwiches. You could probably hear the stock price plummet.
You think so?
Yeah. You would be able to hear it falling.
I mean, I don't know, you know, maybe the stock price goes up.
Oh, you think?
Because you think he's in the market.
You think the discerning computer parts enthusiasts of the world would go, cool. You know what? That's an interesting take he's got.
Son of a bitch has a point.
Yeah. Yeah.
What else were we going to talk about? Oh my God, my editor person's not getting back to me to fucking tell me about this transition. And my edible is going to fucking hit and it's not going to be good.
Oh, it's over for you,
dude.
I also
have to set up my stream deck too. What's new with you, Will?
What is new with me? Oh my goodness. Just got back from Tulum. Very fun.
You were in Tulum?
I was in Tulum.
Where the hell is that again?
Mexico.
Oh.
It's right. Dude, I think we have to do Shitcoon. We have to do a vacation in Cancun.
Okay.
Where everybody goes to Mexico and we go to Tulum.
Uh-huh.
And we just fucking party.
I love it.
Listen, I'm going to tell you right now. Ripped men?
Oh.
There were gaggles of them. Austin.
Oh, dude. I know.
Gaggles of geese.
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
I love it.
Yeah, it'd be fun.
I love men.
I think we need to go all the way live. We just need to send it.
I think so too. I think we should. Is this where we do our streamer orgy where we like stand up and rise up?
Austin, you keep trying to make you're still trying to make this streamer orgy happen. But now that Ludwig and everybody is leaving, you know, we might have more ground to stand on here.
That's all I'm saying. The every streamer that goes to YouTube strengthens our hand.
Strengthens the orgy.
Yeah.
We just get to the point where Twitch is like desperate. And then we're like, guess what? We're all going to fuck on stream. And they're like, why are you doing this?
I think the platform would blow up.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. It would certainly... I don't know if it's the blow up you're thinking of, but it would certainly blow up. The Kotaku article would be a real dense read.
It definitely would. It definitely would.
Yeah.
Oh my God. Hold on. What's up? 1 second. Well, just stay on the line.
Okay. I don't know if
for cool.
Thank you so much for that. I don't know if Austin's doing something difficult and important right now.
He didn't pick up. I'm trying to figure out what the fucking transition that I need to. I just don't know what to do. Is it swipe, slider, stinger?
Stinger.
Stinger, you think?
Tell me what the action is, and I can tell you which one it is.
It's like a.
In between your scenes?
It's. Wait, what?
When you switch from scene to scene.
Here, let me send you the scene.
Okay. When you switch from scene to scene, is it a. Or is it a.
Oh my God, I don't fucking have fucking Discord premium. Or
it's a stinger. It's a stinger.
You think so?
Yeah, guaranteed.
Okay. Let's see if it works.
So look at my screen. Look at my stream right now.
Yeah.
This is a stinger right here. That was a stinger. Okay. Is it like that?
Let's see. Nah, it's a little bit more like flowy.
It's a stinger. You just got to set the duration different.
Okay, I'm just not sure how long the duration is going to be.
How long is the video?
God, don't know.
Look at the duration of the video. It'll tell you how many seconds.
Or it's details, 64 kbps.
Just press play on it and see how many seconds it is, Austin.
Oh, it's 4 seconds.
It's then your transition is 4 seconds.
Okay, yeah. But how many milliseconds? It says transition point. How many milliseconds are in a second? 100? 4,000.
Milli. Thousand.
Okay, I'm gonna do 3,000.
Why would you do 3,000?
It's because I think that's what I had at last. There's some sort of artistic thing you guys wouldn't understand. It's like a thing that we got going on in turn. It's not that you wouldn't understand it. It just takes too much.
How many milliseconds are in 4 seconds? And your answer you came up with was 3,000.
Yes. Son of a bitch.
How, Austin?
My world is falling apart, to be completely honest.
Okay.
Not only is... Here, can I share my screen? Here, let me just share my screen.
I won't fucking share it. I'm gonna help you, Austin. I'm here to help.
All right, I'm gonna share my. You can even probably broadcast this because.
Listen, I just want to tell you, Asan Piker would never do tech support for you right in the middle.
Okay, so
yep,
here we go.
Okay,
I'm just. You can even stream this because it's just my OBS. I think.
Okay.
Actually, I don't know. Does it show my files when I hold on? Wait. Does it show that?
It does not show your files. No, it just shows the one screen you're sharing.
Okay. So you can see that. All right. Now let's put in the transition. Yep. Okay. And we're going to put 3000 ms.
Okay.
For some reason.
Cool.
All right.
Yep.
And you ready for it?
I'm ready.
Oh, that did not look good. Ugh. What the fuck is going on here?
Austin, what has. What?
Why is that split in two?
Awesome. What is
any sense?
What is happening? I don't think you sized it correctly.
Oh, that's just. I didn't even know you had to do that. What do you mean? How does it not sized correctly? It just should be normally. Well, that's not right. Oh, that has never happened before. How is that even possible? Well, let me try it again.
Sure.
Why is that?
Okay.
That's never happened, Will.
Okay, try one of the different settings for it. Let's just see.
Okay. We'll go properties.
Just do a fade.
Oh, that makes... I see what you mean. It's not a stinger.
I think it might be a stinger, but let's just see what happens if you change it to a fade.
I just...
So that's the fade. All right, let's see. Fade.
Okay, hold on. Let's change it to... All right, let's add, fade.
So this will just fade from scene to scene. Do that.
Oh, yeah, wow. Wait, that's for a cool
stinger.
Right, so I'm trying to illustrate to you, the stinger is the animation that happens in between.
Yes.
So put the stinger back on.
Okay.
Yep. And it should be that video you put in, correct? Okay, it's not sized correctly.
Oh my god. What the fuck is going on? I'm really starting to get pissed because I don't know what the fuck I'm doing. I really don't.
No.
Okay, hold on.
You're getting down on yourself.
I'm starting to give up. I don't understand. Defaults, what the hell's going on?
I is there anywhere that you can size your stinger, or is there a stinger properties? I don't use OBS, I use Streamlabs OBS because I'm a boomer.
Well, it's, okay, hold on. There's, oh no. I don't know how to resize the video because there's no option for that. I didn't have to do that last time. It says, okay. It says video file.
Yep.
Okay. So he gave me a tutorial. He gave me this image and I don't know how to decode it. Basically says talent, all right, and then video file, right? Shows the video file.
Yeah.
And then oh shit. All right. So let's add. I just don't know which one it is. Why didn't he tell me which one it was? Are you fucking kidding me?
It's a stinger. It's a stinger, Austin. It's a stinger.
Okay, stinger. Okay, and it's
but there have to be settings.
Okay.
What settings do you have with your stinger other than duration?
I have the video file. Okay. Then I have the transition point, which is 3,000.
Can you share your OBS screen?
Huh?
Okay, you know how you're sharing a specific screen right now? Can you switch it to sharing your monitor so I can actually see what you're doing?
Yeah, but don't show it on the screen because it'll look something.
Okay.
Okay.
It's hidden? Okay.
Share screens. There we go. All right. There we go.
Yep.
Okay.
Okay. Yep. Okay. Yeah. Okay. The transition point is when it flips over. And then
let me try 4,000 milliseconds.
Right. That might help. And then yes. No, it's okay. It's split down the middle. Okay. Go back.
Maybe it's not a stinger.
Try a Luma wipe.
No, that just doesn't sound right. I had instructions in here somewhere. There was like an instructions thing.
Go back to stinger. Trust me. Let me just look at it for a second.
Hold on. How to... See, this is not the one. Okay, stinger. Okay, yeah. You want me to go back to stinger?
And then go to the settings.
Properties.
Props.
Here we go.
Yep. Now... go to preview transition. Okay, it's split down the middle, which is interesting. Go and play me the actual file because it looks like something's fucking up there. Go to the actual file and just try and play the file out of the folder.
Where's the folder here?
Austin, you just have a bar graph on your desktop called porn.
Wait, do I really?
Yeah. It's just a line graph in the bottom of your right-hand monitor, and it just says porn.
Oh, yes.
It's just a line graph. Why do you have a line graph of pornography? Don't worry, I'm not leaking. I saw you panic and go to my stream because you thought I was leaking.
No, I just want to... Okay, look, it's not... It's just basically a graph that says, do you have the habit of visiting pornographic websites?
Yes.
And
Thank you, Mini Bro, by the way, for the
gifted subs. And it showed that everybody visits pornographic websites in some capacity.
Yes.
And then I was talking, I think I put that in Hosscord or something.
Okay, go to...
What I was trying to say is, like, why is so many people against porn when everybody watches it?
That is true. All right, go back to your folder with the files. Stop looking at me. Where is the stinger?
It's right here.
Click it. Double click it.
Hold on. Oh, hold on.
Oh, okay. Yeah, wow. That's for a cool.
14 months. That's two more than 12.
Okay,
just
so
a fun fact smile.
Video file.
Just double click where the stinger is.
Oh, it says use track mat. What does that mean?
Track?
How do I hit that button? Is my OBS...
Oh my gosh. I will find it.
Hold on. Hold on, let me see. Well, we don't have to do this on your stream. I just realized we're literally broadcasting.
Okay. Stinger transition and OBS studio overlays. Cut transition between two sources.
I think I need to update.
A selection of free track mat stingers has been added. Okay.
Wait, what's the newest? Let's see, Windows. Oh, yeah. Let me do this real quick. Hold on. This is the problem, Will. Tools, help. Can you? Oh God, I'm so fucking, this is not good. The race against time is.
I found it. There should be a toggleable feature called use a track mat.
Yeah, but that's on the new version. I need to update.
Oh yes. You're just in the wrong version of OBS.
Yeah.
Okay. So you're good.
So just let me figure that out real quick.
Okay.
Will it update or is it going to like be a whole new?
Yeah, it's going to update.
Okay, hold on.
You're probably going to have to restart.
Okay, well, we can talk about something else while it's updating.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah, sorry.
You're welcome.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
Anyway, what were you talking about? How are you enjoying being in 100 Thieves?
It's pretty good. I like it a lot. I like my team.
Yeah.
Our team is pretty poggers.
I think our team is pretty poggers.
I like hanging out with the people on our team.
Me too.
They are fun.
I agree. I 100% agree. So you know what I love about 100 Thieves?
What's that?
So much.
Tell me.
Is that you're in it?
I mean, that's true.
I love it.
Oh,
23 months. Let's celebrate. I love Christmas time.
Okay.
I've been listening to Christmas music since.
Did you break the Mariah Carey seal?
Oh God, are you kidding me? The first song, Christmas song I listened to during the Christmas season was Oh Santa, da 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 da, better gonna make me wait. Then come down the day, bells up on your sleigh.
Dude, it's now it's definitely Christmas time. It's time to drink nog. Austin, did you know that there are people who drink nog as early as October?
That sounds fucking bomb. Eggnog sounds incredible right now.
Wait a minute. Right now, but I'm talking about people who buy and consume eggnog as early as Halloween.
Oh.
This is sus behavior, in my opinion.
Do you really think so?
Consuming nog before November is deeply sus to me.
Really?
Yeah, it's insane.
Okay, well... Before you say that,
yeah.
One second. Check it out. You ready?
Oh, I'm looking at your stream again. Okay, hold on. Yep, here we go. Tech support. Let's see it.
Ready?
Yep. Oh hell yeah! I'll show it on stream.
The sound?
Oh yeah, I could hear the jingle. Play it again. Let's see it. Nice.
You like that?
That's a good transition, sir.
It is, and it's very magical.
It's very Disney.
I don't know. I don't know. I didn't make it.
I know you didn't make it. You couldn't even figure out how to turn it on.
Dude, I literally look like I'm...
Dude, were you worried for a second that I thought that... Hey, Will, I programmed this transition. I just don't know how to turn it on.
Dude, look at this. Look at this. I mean, I look like I'm in a fucking bunker.
A bunker? Let me see. Is that a green screen?
Yeah.
Is this where you stream from now?
Yeah.
I'm a stud.
Why is your green screen so small?
No shit from anyone.
I'm AustinShow, and you're watching the Disney Channel.
I am AustinShow, and you're watching Disney. Hey, Austin, can you do like the thing they used to do on Disney Channel where they trace the shape of the ears for me right now? Wow. This kid's got a gift.
Can you imagine if the Disney transition just stopped and it was like...
Bro, that's a great sketch. Some Disney Channel star gets rip shit stoned and then cannot trace the Disney symbol. They're like, Ariana, one more time. Here we go.
She's just like.
Nope. Very close.
Well, let's go over to the show tomorrow, Will.
Wait. Austin. Go back. I need you to trace the Disney shape and then hit the transition.
Okay.
Ready? You could do this and say you're watching Disney Channel. Go.
You're watching Disney Channel.
It was everything I thought it would be. It was so good.
That's funny.
And I think that's a perfect way to announce that you are leaving Twitch and going to Disney Plus streaming.
Yeah, right.
I mean,
that's it, guys. That's it, folks.
That's the big one.
That's the big one. That's right. Don't worry, folks.
The first member of Disney Plus streaming.
Don't worry, guys. I'm almost proud to announce that I'm not going anywhere.
I'm proud of you. I just hear you transitioning over and over again in the background.
Here, I'll stop streaming. There we go. What the hell's going on here?
Yes.
Oh.
Yes.
I just need to make sure that my... All right. So I think I've figured out the transition. Sure. That's good.
Mm-hmm.
And it's all good. I'm feeling good about things.
Good. I'm glad I could help. That's pretty pog of me.
No worries. Thank you. Wait, what? Why am I saying no worries?
I don't know. I think you're pretty gone now. I think I should just...
No, I'm good. I'm not done setting up yet. I need to set up my... streamer deck.
I think I should let you go set up.
No. I want to continue talking to you. Please.
Wait a minute. Is this how you just get me to do tech support?
By the way, can I tell you a story?
Sure, yeah.
The other day, okay. I was, I went to the gym. Yes. Right? Did my normal routine, went to the gym. And after the gym, I went to go get a sandwich.
Okay.
So I go to the gym, I go get a sandwich.
Yep.
Afterwards, then I go home and I eat the sandwich, right? And then I go to my computer and I sit down. And, okay. I shower and then I sit down at my computer. And I do.
Okay, is this a story or are you
no,
just...
No, wait. It's not over yet. So I'm sitting at my computer. I sit there for about 2 hours, take a couple of meetings.
Sure.
And in walks this Swedish guy. I'm just kidding. Anyway, hold on 1 second. All right. So this situation that I'm in, I'm watching Twitch or whatever. I have a couple of meetings too. I'm taking meetings. And then I'm ready to go to an in-person meeting because I had an in-person meeting today. And I'm like, okay, where's my wallet? And I look around the place. I'm like, where's the wallet? I don't know where my wallet is. Can't find it. I'm like, fuck it. I'm just going to go without my wallet. Went without my wallet. I'll find it when I get home. Then I get back home. I tear my place apart. Couch. Go through the garbage can. Everything. My wallet is nowhere to be found. Nowhere to be found at all. I've never lost my wallet before. So immediately, I'm calling my credit card companies. I'm having to listen to them list off all the recent charges, which also happens to include several OnlyFans subscription charges
sure.
that I have to confirm that are my own.
Sure.
And not, you know, thing that they're like, OnlyFans subscription for $14.99 on Sunday. Was that you? Yes. Oh, yes, it was me. Anyway, so I do that. I cancel. I'm like, fuck, I lost my wallet. I have to get a new ID. I got to get a new credit card, new debit card, everything. The next day, I wake up. Oh, by the way, that night I went to the sandwich spot. I was thinking, oh, God, the wallet's somewhere. Sandwich spot didn't have it. I'm like, fuck, okay, it's over. I went to the grocery store. I was like, you guys have it? No, it's over. So the next day, I'm like, okay. I've lost. So I went to the bank. I got the new card. I went to the, you know, I was like, okay, I got to make an appointment for my license. I ordered a new credit card to be. So then I'm like, you know what? I'm going to go to the restaurant next to the place that I dropped my wallet. Or I feel like I, you know, that I, the next to the place, right? So I go there, last ditch, Hail Mary, the restaurant next door. And I'm like, hey, did you guys by chance find a wallet? And the guy says, yeah. In fact, I did. I said, okay. And he's like, what's your name? I said, Austin. He's like, well, here you go. And that guy had my wallet in his hand. What had happened is when I left the sandwich shop, I opened the door for a woman who had her hands full. And in that time, I dropped my wallet. And some good Samaritan picked up my wallet and carried it into what they thought was the store that sold my wallet or that I, whatever, fuck it. So at the end of this story, I want to let you know something, that it always pays to be kind to one another.
Except for the fact that if you hadn't opened the door, you would have just kept your wallet.
That's a great point.
Oh yeah,
I didn't actually think
of
that. Austin,
I didn't actually think of that part. Had I been a rude son of a bitch and dropped the door, I could have saved myself a lot of fucking time.
Yeah, but hey, you know, it's a karma story. I like that. Got your wallet back.
Are you just saying being a dickhead is just a shortcut in life?
No. You got the wallet back.
It would have never needed to happen to you had you just been a dick to begin with.
You were nice and you got your wallet back.
Yeah, but if I wasn't nice to begin with, I would have never lost my wallet.
That's true.
Anyway, long story short. Oh, actually, this is it. I had another wallet that I got for Christmas like 2 years ago that I just never used. And
is this another wallet story?
No, and I got this wallet. Well, it became my new wallet because I lost the other one, so I thought. And this is what I discovered. I was in the sandwich store, and I open up the wallet, and in the wallet, $150 cash.
What?
I didn't know it was there. I had no idea I had it. So because of that, I got $150 in cash because I was nice to that woman and held her door.
This happened all in the same wallet controversy?
Yes, all this. I didn't know I had $150. What had happened is